So we all start out as a novice of some kind. It's not to say that we're not smart, you know, they're really smart people. But if you don't have a lot of experience, you're kind of in that novice position. And so what you need to do is follow a kind of a winding path to figure out what you like to do, what you're good at. Some people, you know, talk about zone of genius, things like that, you know, figuring that out. And so the first evolution is where you get to be this generalist invisible expert. So you're really good at what you do. You can get results for your clients, but you're not really known broadly. You don't have any visibility. So I say like you're wearing a cloak of invisibility, like in Harry Potter.
I love it.
and so you're typically, all of your business is coming from referrals and word of mouth at this point.
Yeah.
And a lot of people stay here. In fact, the vast majority of people stay here. And they don't want to go on and build their authority, because you can actually earn a very good living. You could earn as a subject matter expert, as an independent consultant, you could be earning, you know, mid six figures in this area if you're good at what you do and you have a good network. Mm-hmm. But some people do want to move on, and they want to become known as an authority in their field, become the recognized authority in their field. And if you want to get up to here, to where people literally put you on a pedestal, you know, you're standing at a podium, you're invited to speak. In order to get there, the key phrase is in your field. So you're the recognized authority in your field. You actually have to pick a field. You have to pick a specialization. You have to niche down. And so how I see it is, to get to there, you have to go through this process of going through this like I've pictured as a mountain range where you've got to go through this difficult process, and sometimes it's very time consuming. It takes quite a while to do it, but finding what your niche is, and starting to niche down and becoming an expert in your niche, and if you do that and spend time at that, you will go on to become an authority in your field.
Mm-hmm.
There are certain things you need to do at the same time. To be known as an authority, you have to publish. And typically you'll be speaking as well. And I'm including things like this live stream as a speaking, you know, you will be speaking. You're probably doing some kind of research. It could be small scale research. It doesn't have to be, you know, major commercial scale or kind of, you know, it doesn't have to be kind of peer research. It can just be small scale research, but you are doing something to learn about what your expert area is, to have that deeper understanding than people who are competing with you who are generalists. But if you go through the specialization phase and then go on to do research and publishing and speaking, you will become a recognized authority in your field. So that's how I see that evolution.